With almost 500 sessions at Next 2018, it's understandable that you couldn't get into them all. So if you didn't see GCP 101, then stay tuned, because here's the rewind. Starting on Google Cloud can be overwhelming at first. There are over 40 products spread over a huge set of cloud technologies like machine learning, containers, or big data. It can be hard to decide where to dig in. In my talk, I took people on a journey of someone bringing their first test application to Google Cloud Platform. Let's see if we can't shed some light on this path and help you figure out where you want to go with GCP. One of the first things anybody coming to any cloud does is what we call a lift and shift. That's when you pick up an app that's running in your current environment and drop it to another. Now, most people start this process from existing systems running on either bare metal host or virtual machines of their own, usually in their own data centers. On the cloud side of this move, virtual machines are really the basic building block of the solution. And on Google Cloud Platform, that means Compute Engine. Now, I'm going to attempt to explain all the benefits of Compute Engine in the time it takes me to get one of our virtual machines up and running. But first, let's jump into the console to create it. You see here I have options around which of our worldwide data centers that you can host your VMs. I can change the machine size or the boot disk, set basic firewall options, and even choose to launch a container image by itself in a virtual machine. I'm going to largely choose the defaults here and launch. Then I'm going to take a deep breath, and then I'm going to try and spell out all the benefits of Compute Engine before it finishes launching. So, Compute Engine instances are highly configurable VMs that allow you to choose both preset and custom amounts of processor memory and processor platforms. You have several disk storage options, including networked SSD and attached SSD. Use any of our disk images based on several flavors of Linux or Windows to start or bring your own customized image. You can also take advantage of some more specialized computing resources like GPUs and TPUs. You can manage all of your VMs regardless of where in the world they are on one screen and one interface. And this just isn't a feature of the console for managing them. All of your VMs are on the same network by default with no manual setup required to get your VM in Sydney to talk to your VM in London. And we're done. And you can tell we're done because we have this little SSH button. So I couldn't get it done in the time it took to launch. But let's go ahead. We'll SSH in. So now we'll use that to connect right to the VM through the browser. No pulling down and customizing certs, setting up all the necessary security. We'll do that for you. From here, I can customize my VM, installing whatever software I need to start making it mine. So, but I don't have to SSH directly into the box to do that. With the gCloud CLI tools, I can do everything I need to do to make this machine mine right from the comfort of my own terminal window. Pure lift and shift really only requires a virtual machine, but moving to the cloud allows you to take advantage of a lot of systems that you can't duplicate in your own environment. Things like distributed storage, distributed databases, or machine learning APIs and big data tools. In the full video, I spoke about how best to take an application that you brought to the cloud via lift and shift and re-architect it to take advantage of everything that Google Cloud has to offer. I go over using cloud storage and cloud SQL to make your app much more scalable. I also explored some of the other computing options that open up to you when you make those architecture changes. Finally, I'll point you to a number of other tools that you can use to improve your application, including machine learning APIs and logging and other communication tools. If you'd like to see the full talk, check out the link in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe to the Cloud YouTube channel for more great Next Rewind content. Thanks for watching.